The Season 3 premiere of NGW British Wrestling Weekly is proudly sponsored by Fighting Spirit Magazine.
Absolute breaking point. fans.
Well, that's NGW's open door policy in full effect, and, well, we've got music. This doesn't sound very familiar, and I'm pretty much well-versed in all the entrance things here in NGW.
It sounds like someone's gonna...
That's former NGW Tag Team Champion Sam Bailey. We've not seen him for about 2 years in NGW. What's he doing here?
Sam Bailey? Looking like he's going to answer the challenge, but Alex, he's on his own. It's a tag team challenge.
This crowd haven't forgot him.
What are you going to blame that? Sam, you're on your own. There's two of the best athletes in British wrestling in this ring. You've got no chance to shine.
Well, Ritchie West might be right. I'm not sure Sam Bailey's thought this plan through. He's going to need another person.
Hold on. He's saying it's not two against one, it's two against two. But, well, this... Talk about changing everything that we had planned for this episode. We've got huge news coming up on this episode of British Wrestling Weekly. But the huge news might be who's the tag partner here with Sam Bailey.
Oh, that's Liam Slater! Liam Slater is here with Sam Bailey!
Well, listen to this crowd in the whole City Hall. Liam Slater is one of the most popular men here from the NGW Academy onto NGW British Wrestling Weekly. And it was announced just this past week that Liam Slater, in 2 weeks' time, is finally going to get that singles match against Joe Connors, who's been kept off television.
Well, here come Bailey and Slater, and, well, the Proven didn't stay in town very long, did they?
Well, this is a strange situation, because Liam Slater and Joe Connors has been one of the most heated rivalries we've had in New Generation Wrestling in quite some time. But Slater, without the handcuffs, the restrictions of that rivalry, it looks like it's the old Liam Slater.
Certainly Joseph Connor's not here today. We're waiting for that match against Slater in 2 weeks for the first time Connors is scheduled to appear on this series of NGW British Wrestling Weekly. And yeah, without those shackles, maybe Liam Slater can focus on the Proven tonight.
Well, there's a big history between Liam Slater and The Proven. Just to give you a backstory on it, Dave, The Proven came from the NGW Academy, and they were the standouts of that school from the class before Liam. They sided with Ritchie West and went, shall we say, over to the dark side. But Liam Slater came in the next generation of students and has become as loved as The Proven is disliked.
And again, Slater has a lot of history with The Proven, not just when he was in the NGW Academy. His first television victory was in a six-man tag match in which two of the opponents were Kaz Crash and Sam Wilder.
And his first tag team victory was also against The Proven, but he's yet to score that elusive singles victory, and it may come at the hands of Joe Connors in 2 weeks' time.
Slater is dominating Wilder as this match gets underway. Referee Craig Anderson letting Liam Slater just have at it against Sam Wilder.
And this is not going the way that Ritchie West would have hoped for, because Ritchie West has had some very bad news this week. More on that later.
Slater sends Wilder to the ropes. Big hip toss. And Wilder is retreating.
And it looks like Slater, it looks like he's going for that dive. He wants to be careful because Sam Wilder.
Maybe looking worried, but Slater was not going to dive after all.
That trademark dance, Dave, that made him so popular to begin with.
Slater certainly having fun in Hull City Hall at the expense of The Proven.
And if this is any shade of what we're going to see in 2 weeks' time when Slater takes on Joe Connors, then that one is going to be very interesting indeed. Blind tag there, did you see that?
Bailey is in, but I don't think Wilder saw it. No, he didn't. Flying back elbow from Sam Bailey. God, it's great to have him back.
And don't forget, this guy was one half of the NGW Tag Team Champions. You know who with, Dave? Zach Gibson. So this guy has got incredible tag team credentials. Look at the depth of that arm drag.
Bailey looking like he hasn't lost a step in the time he's been away. Kaz Prash immediately on the defensive.
Oh, look at that.
Well, that's one way out.
Straight to the eye, and referee Craig Anderson there rightfully reprimanding Kaz Prash. This young man is vicious.
He's into the corner, and Bailey with a headstand.
This is vintage Sam Bailey, and Kaz Prash here looking a bit bewildered, as he should.
We've got to go to a commercial break. Bailey and Slater against the Prudent continues when we come back.
WrestlePlus.com is the brand new home of incredible online wrestling content, featuring uncensored shoot interview classics, full series of WrestleTalk TV and British Wrestling Weekly, exclusive documentaries, wrestling's biggest names before they were stars, an incredible podcast collection, up to 90% off merchandise offers, and the brand new Power Slammed e-magazine forwarded by Finn Martin himself. WrestlePlus has thousands of hours of content with new and exclusive releases added regularly. You can join today for the stupidly low price of just £4.99 a month. Wrestle Plus, because this is wrestling.
Back here on NTW British Wrestling Weekly, Sam Bailey goes for a cover, and Bailey and Slater continuing to take the fight to the Proven out.
I've been impressed so far with Sam Bailey and Liam Slater, because considering these guys have never teamed up before, whoa, I spoke too soon there. That's Crash. Big clothesline, and you can't write out the Proven under the tutelage of Richie West.
That's Crash, a big guy, very well put together. Probably the most powerful man in this match. Sam Wilder may be the sneakiest man in this match. Referee didn't see that.
And you've got to give him credit, yeah, and Richie West just does, because that was perfect double teaming right behind referee Craig Anderson's back.
Crash working on that right knee of Bailey. He tags in Wilder. This is good tag team strategy from the Proven, keeping Bailey isolated in their own corner.
And I know Sam Bailey very well, Dave, because I in fact trained Sam Bailey 10 years ago, over 10 years ago. So this guy had a decade of experience.
Come on.
Wow.
Breath.
But there's no amount of experience that can prepare you for a 3-on-1 like that, and that's exactly what it was.
Richie West getting his shots in on Bailey as Wilder continues to just strike and pound on Sam Bailey. Another quick tag, in comes Kaz Prash.
And now would be a good time to mention that this week Richie West had very, very bad news. I know you're going to cover it in more detail before the end of the hour, Dave, but this week it was announced that Mark Haskins, due to the various headshots that he received in that match with Sami Callihan, Mark Haskins has not been cleared to wrestle in that big 8-man tag match.
Yeah, that's huge. We'll be talking more about that later. Certainly leaves Richie West and the Proven in a bit of a quandary. They've got a vacancy now in that 8-man tag match.
It's big news, and talking of big news, possibly the biggest news that we've had all year is going to be announced before the end of the programme, Dave. I know what it is. I've been sort of privy to the information, and all I can say is you don't want to miss it. And look at this.
Yeah, an absolutely enormous announcement coming up, but Sam Bailey at this rate might not be conscious when the announcement is made. He's getting absolutely pummeled by the Proven. Kaz Prash goes for a cover and only gets two.
And Liam Slater was played like a fiddle there by two young men who have the minds of veterans, because never forget that the managing director of NGW and possibly the most cunning man in British wrestling today, Richie West, is shouting assistance from right down there in the corner. And oh, do you see the way that the ankle of Sam Bailey twisted there?
Yeah, it also would take a knee out of a socket, wouldn't it? Every way a leg is not supposed to twist, and that move right there as Wilder comes in, drops the elbow, and again they'll go for a cover. He's got that leg hook, got him wrapped up quite well in fact, but again only a two count.
And this has got to be heartbreaking for Liam Slater, because this man was on such a winning streak around a year ago until that rivalry with Joe Connors, high impact. And since then, his star has dropped at a steady rate. So you've got to believe that Liam Slater wants a win here in the worst way possible. But from where he is now, it's a long way from happening.
Slater looked a like he was having some fun in the early part of this match. Hang on, Bailey with the counter into the small package, and he gets two. So it looked like he was having fun early on, and that's a good thing to see, because this rivalry he's had with Connors has really kind of brought out a dark side in Liam Slater that we've never seen before.
And there's a reason that Joe Connors has been kept off of this season of British Wrestling Weekly so far, but that absence will end in just 2 weeks' time when he goes one-on-one with Slater, and you've got to believe that is in the mind of Slater and also NGW management, because Joe Connors is a dangerous man. These two guys, I want to understand where the chip on the Proven shoulder came from.
They just, more than almost anyone else on the NGW roster, they just look like they're enjoying administering this beating that they do every week against their opponents.
Tag!
In comes Slater!
And look at Slater, this guy's on fire!
Slater exploding out of his corner! A shoulder block takes down Wilder!
And this crowd in Hull City Hall is going insane here. Slater charges, Crash Crash follows in, but Slater moves good.
Crash and Wilder, the Proven, in the corner. Here comes Slater.
And it's the price you pay when you leave one man on the outside for all that time. And Slater now.
The Proven are rocking and reeling.
You know what he's going for, Dave? Check this out. Senton elbow drop. Lands hard
on both of them. Slater is lining up Wilder. That's the Nelson position. Takes down Wilder and he's going for the cover. Kaz Crash saves the match.
Well, Richie West having a conniption fit there at ringside. And Kaz Crash, I've said it, second time in this match, give the Proven credit, because these guys are a royal oil tag team machine. And it makes you wonder if NGW against Team Control stands a chance. Because when it comes to working up a unit, the Proven and the Control have it well, well mastered.
Here we go. Hang on.
Dave,
go for that. Point proven.
That's it. It was close, but this one is
won. Bailey saves it. So first Kaz Crash saves for the Proven, then Bailey saves the match for Slater. Crash to the outside.
Talk about Crash living up to his name. Strains that guardrail. And Wilder now knows that he has to do something and do something desperate.
Wilder is charging. Bailey moves.
He's on the top, Dave.
Slater, Slater with the cover. That's one, two, and three.
That's
three. Liam Slater picks up the win. Liam Slater and Sam Bailey, in their first time ever working as a tag team, have beaten the Proven. And Alex, what does this do for Richie West's plans for that 8-man tag match?
Well, this is incredible, because Liam Slater is now on a path towards Joe Connors, but it's a path that has regained momentum. Liam's young brother Dan Slater was here at ringside, and what a moment to win this match in front of his family and in front of the world on British Wrestling Weekly. Wow.
Liam Slater again picking up a win against the Proven. That's what, at least the third time in his career. Not many people can ever say that.
Well, in NGW, that win was big news. But when it comes to worldwide wrestling big news, we are going to have that before the end of this broadcast, because our biggest announcement so far this season is coming up before the end of the hour. But the men of the hour right now are Liam Slater and Sam Bailey, an incredible victory.
That's right, a huge announcement coming up. We'll also, as you said, Alex, have news on Mark Haskins before the end of the show. Bailey and Slater, I can't get over that. To beat the Proven, when there he is, Slater is hugging his brother.
16-year-old Dan Slater, and that's a moment that will live with him for a long time.
Anyway, we're going to go to the studio. Francesca Wood is there.
Thanks, Dave. We're in the studio right now and we're about to announce the huge British wrestling news very shortly, so make sure you stay tuned for that.
Well, from one big story in our tag team division to another, right now we're going to hear from one of the two men who a couple of weeks ago lost the NGW tag team titles to Team Insane Fight Club. The heavyweight House of Pain, Styx, has had a couple of weeks to reflect.
Whoa, oh, hang on.
Is feeling the pressure from Mark Haskins no longer being in the match.
Well, the stakes for NGW's team warfare could not be higher. Anyway, as I was saying before that, let's go here from Styx. I'm not even sure who the legal man is.
Well, there's no referee to count the cover. He's losing control of this. Oh, Dave!
Oh, Hendry, what was that? Hendry had the belt!
No,
cover!
No way!
Oh my God! Champions!
We have brand new NGW Tag Team Champions, and look, they're trading the belts around amongst themselves. How is this going to be rectified?
See, I could be sat here blaming the fact that it was 3-2 as to why I don't have a belt anymore, but I'm not going to. You see, you're up there in Scotland mocking us. You want to make this Scotland versus England, and it's not about that. You want to make this like gang warfare? Then Colossus and I can do that just as well as any other thing. Because the UK's biggest tag team are coming for you. And you thought we were big and bad before? We're going to come for you bigger and badder than ever. It doesn't matter if it's in Hull, if it's in Liverpool, or if we have to come to Scotland. We are coming to get our belts back.
Welcome back to NGW British Wrestling Weekly. I'm Francesca Wood, and I've been joined in the studio once again by our two outspoken wrestling pundits. First, it's former British heavyweight champion Alex Shane.
Hello.
And from the WrestleTalk YouTube channel, it's Ollie Davis.
Hello.
Hello. Now, guys, we have a big announcement coming up before the end of the show. But before that, let's talk about one of the biggest matches in NGW history as we head towards Total Team Warfare. Nathan Cruz will put his undisputed title on the line as he captains a four-man NGW team against The Control, captained by Rampage Brown. However, there's been a huge setback for Richie West and his group. Take a look at this.
Well, thanks to NGW's open door policy, some of the best wrestlers in the world are lining up to compete against the best of British. So perhaps it was no surprise that with Mark Haskins and the USA's Sammy Callahan competing on a global stage, something had to give. So you see here a hugely competitive match between the two men, and although Mark Haskins would eventually win the match, he took so much punishment, so many shots to the head on his way to victory that 24 hours after this match, Haskins collapsed. Now, his diagnosis has not been made public. He is going to be okay in the long term, but he has not been cleared to wrestle in team warfare for The Control, leaving Richie West with an enormous dilemma. Just who can and will fill the star attraction's shoes?
So, with The Control team officially one man down ahead of this huge 3 years in the making showdown, what does our panel think Richie West of The Control will do? Ollie?
Well, quite simply, he's got to find another person, hasn't he, to make it a four-man
team. Anyone you suggest?
I don't know. I mean, I've always thought Zach Gibson, there's something in between about him. He's never either on one sort of side or the other, bit of a lone wolf. So I can see him being persuaded. But again, you know, they've had run-ins in the past. Last year, they had a big feud, Gibson and Richie West in The Control. So I don't know.
I think Zach Gibson's got a record of saying that he didn't think the relationship between him and Nathan Cruz could get much worse than it was going into the Ultimate Showdown, and it has got worse. But I would say the only relationship equal to the negativity between Gibson and Cruz is Gibson and Rampage Brown. So no matter what offer Richie West gave towards Zach Gibson, I can't imagine a world in which those two guys could be a cohesive tag team. But I wouldn't be surprised if Richie West leveraged the fact that you've got all these channels around the world airing this show now to bring somebody in from the outside. You know, there's a lot of people knocking on the NGW door, open door policy. I mean, there's a lot of people. I mean, Sami Callihan, you know, for example, we saw his match with Haskins. He's the guy responsible, but somebody like that, it was a fantastic match. But the consequences of that match, obviously, is what's created this situation in the first place.
Well, not only for everyone around the world, it's also a really good opportunity for everyone on the NGW roster. This is really a chance to prove themselves. They get in with the control, and then they're in the main event.
OK, guys, so I guess the real question is, do you agree or disagree with the decision to not allow Haskins to compete within the competition?
After you?
I think it's... I mentioned at the time, I thought the match went too far. It wasn't just the refereeing, but it was just the level of, I don't want to say brutality, but let's just say intense competition. And I watched it as a commentator and I was uncomfortable. So I think that if NGW management have said that due to Haskins collapsing the following day and the fear for his safety, particularly because we know this match is going to be intense, there's 3 years of history slash baggage involved in it. If they don't feel that he's in the right condition physically to take part in it, I think it was a good call, quite honestly.
But if Richie West is, he's the head of the control and he owns the company.
He's the managing director, he doesn't own the company, yeah.
Well, sure, that gives him, he can just overrule this, right? And to say Mark Haskins is going in whether you like it or not.
Well, no, you can't, because in the way a company works, you can be, as a managing director, you can be replaced. But the shareholders have the right to say, we're going to replace the managing director. And something like Mark Haskins collapsing the day after this match is enough for a shareholder to say, hold on a second. So that's the advantage that you know, or the disadvantage, I guess, that Richie West has.
Yeah.
And the advantage the shareholders have.
I mean, I think it's a bit... obviously, I'm in an awkward position here because I don't want to argue against safety. I don't want people to get intentionally hurt. But that match that Haskins and Callihan had was incredible. That was one of the best matches I've seen all year. And Haskins is a grown-up man. If there is a long time between now and that match, that eight-man tag match that he would be involved in, I think sometimes you've got to let the wrestlers decide for themselves.
Well, I mean, I come at it from a different perspective because I was a wrestler and I took a lot of big bumps and I did a lot of crazy stunts and I went into many matches injured. And at the time I thought, well, I'm fine to do this. But years later, now my body's paying a toll. So sometimes if you leave it in the hands of the wrestler or the performer, they're always going to say their leg could be hanging off and they would say, I want to do it. But ultimately, sometimes somebody has to stand up and say, are you in the right condition? And the doctors, not just NGW management, but the doctor said they don't think he would be. So it's what it is, you know.
It's what it is. Like when Kurt Angle won the Olympic gold medal for amateur wrestling with a broken neck. I mean, that's the big one, isn't it?
And he's walked with a hunch ever since.
Yeah.
Okay, well, you can let us know what you think about the entire situation online right now by using the hashtag NGWUK. Next, however, let's take you back to the shocking conclusion of last week's Gen X League number one contenders match and hear from two of the men involved.
Oh, no! No, wait!
Wild ball!
Oh! Davies hits it!
Davies pile driver!
No one has ever kicked out of that!
It's over!
British look what's happening!
Well, now Gordon doesn't go for the distraction. He's telling Linsky to count!
It's a battle of wills between Gordon and Linsky! And look, Linsky is just...
Well, Gordon's getting off the apron. He wants Linsky to count. Wow. Now he does! Now he does! And it's over!
Oh! Oh! My God!
Matt Myers kicked out!
Seen anyone kick out of that. Listen to this.
And boy, did that distraction from Gordon backfire.
Gordon has put, I mean, that, and Boar's just lost it. Boar has lost it. And Gilligan Gordon, mate.
Well, yeah, strategy's gone out the window. Linsky, I think
wow.
Boar was using a closed fist.
Well, we spoke about the pressure that Linsky was under, but can you believe the way that this one is blown up? Wow. This is crazy, and it, Walker gets suspended here. Look at Gilligan saying, take your hands off him. Dave, this is a volatile situation.
Linsky has snapped. That boy is going to try and finish it with another.
Oh,
package powder. Oh, Gordon falls off the ring apron. And hang on.
Oh,
my
Myers Stunner! No way!
You ask me to come here and do these stupid things where I have to sit down and talk about what's happened, like it's some kind of therapy session, like it's some kind of vent your spleen moment. Steve Linsky got in my business, another screwy referee, costing me money, costing more opportunities, costing me everything that I'm trying to build. And people say the problems are between Gilligan Gordon and the wild boar. No! The problems are with NGW management and Gilligan Gordon. You sit me here, you strap a microphone to me, and you ask me to talk about the problems with Gilligan and the boar. There are no problems. Pick up the phone and talk to me at a better time and I'll tell you. There are no Gilligan Gordon problems. There's only Gilligan Gordon solutions. I don't need to tell you. I don't need to say. Gilligan Gordon and the Wild Boar are as cohesive as ever. And if you thought we were dangerous before, you people have not seen anything yet.
You know, last time I sat in this chair, I said, you know, I was going to beat Wild Boar. And I'll admit, there was a little bit of doubt in there, but I knew I could do it. And that is exactly what I did. I probably proved you wrong. I like to think I proved everyone else wrong. And I can tell you now, the next stop and my next victory will be Bubblegum. You know, last time I was in the ring with you, Bubblegum, the time ran out. And I said, you know, guaranteed just a couple more minutes, I would have won that match. And since then, I've actually done a few more Gen X matches and I've adapted my style for those matches. I know how quick I need to be on the mark, what I need to be doing and when. You know, and I tell you now, Bubblegum, you know, I've watched the tape and I saw that I was just half a second away. But this time when we meet again, I'm going to be half a second quicker, half a second faster. I'm going to be that little bit better and I can guarantee that I'm going to be the next Gen X champion.
And don't forget that Gen X champion Bubblegum takes on El Ligero in just 7 days' time on this very show. So don't miss it. Coming up next, however, it's time for our very big announcement. This is NGW British Wrestling Weekly. Don't you dare go anywhere. We'll be right back. To NGW British Wrestling Weekly. Now, you've waited long enough, so it's finally time for our big announcement. And it relates to British wrestling on a global stage. And it's an exciting one indeed. Check this out.
On a global stage, arguably the most successful British wrestling star of all time is the legendary British Bulldog, Davey Boy Smith. In 2014, to honour Davey's legacy, his daughter, Georgia Smith, launched the first ever Davey Boy Smith Memorial Cup. The tournament's qualifying matches over the next few months were a who's who of British wrestling and included the first ever nationally televised matches for the likes of the winner of TNA British Boot Camp 2, Mark Andrews, Best of the Super Juniors 2016, Will Ospreay, current Gen X Cup holder Bubblegum, current NGW Undisputed Champion Nathan Cruz, and the man who would eventually go on to win the cup, Zach Gibson.
That first moment that I made that big impact, it is when NGW gave me the opportunity to compete in the Davey Boy Cup. Obviously, it was the first of its kind, but it's already a prestigious cup, and it's something that I'm very, very proud of, to win that tournament, to also have my final match in the tournament in my home city, and to represent a legend like Davey Boy. That's something that I'm always going to be proud of. That's something that put me on the map.
Following the success of the inaugural tournament, NGW British Wrestling Weekly is proud to announce the second Davey Boy Smith Memorial Cup. Much like last time, the centrepiece of the tournament will be a four-man round-robin allowing each competitor to showcase their abilities against three different opponents. Those four finalists will once again be hand-picked by the Smith and Hart families. To help them with their decision over the coming months, NGW will be hosting a series of open invitational contests. Although no names have yet been announced for this second tournament, what we do know is that the current NGW Undisputed Champion and the current holder of the Davey Boy Smith Memorial Cup will not be eligible to compete. Stay tuned to NGW British Wrestling Weekly over the coming months as the Davey Boy Smith Memorial Cup Tournament returns.
So British Wrestling's longest running televised tournament returns. The Davey Boy Smith Memorial Cup is back and you'll be able to watch it exclusively right here on NGW British Wrestling Weekly. Now guys, what do you want to see from the Cup?
Well, I mean, for people that aren't really familiar with the first one, it was awesome. So many things started in that first tournament. For example, the rivalry between Zach Gibson and Nathan Cruz. Their first ever confrontation was in the qualifiers of that cup. People like Mark Andrews, who won British Boot Camp 2, Marty Skell, who hosted WrestleTalk TV and just making waves on the indies in America, and also Will Ospreay.
Will Ospreay.
All of those guys got their first national television exposure in the Davey Boy Smith Cup. And, you know, because of that, and Zach Gibson, we should mention, obviously, he's mentioned it enough, went on to win that. So if you think about Davey Boy Smith, this was a guy who came from England, from British wrestling, went over to Canada, where the Fight Network is based, who broadcasts us around the world, and then from there went to the WWF and became one of the biggest stars ever to come from Europe, possibly the biggest star ever to come from England. And to have his family, his daughter, Georgia Smith, and Diana Hart Smith, found this tournament, it was a big, big deal when it first happened, and now we've got a second one. It's a real world story, and the one thing that I will conclude with is when we did that, British wrestling on television, when we did that first tournament, was very new. Now it's got some experience of wrestling on television, and the talent scene is huge, so I think it could be a really, really, like a game-changing tournament.
All those names you just mentioned, Will Ospreay, who's tearing it up now in New Japan, Marty Skell, who's one of my favourite wrestlers, you know, just at the moment, and Mark Andrews, who went on to TNA. This is where you'll see the next bunch of guys. All those people who will go on in 2-3 years to that similar level of success, that's where you'll see them. So it's really exciting, I can't wait.
And I think because we've got, you know, what's different this year is we're going to have these open invitationals. Mm-hmm. So it will be the Smith and the Hart family that will pick the people that go in that tournament. But the open invitationals are almost like, the best way to explain it is it puts you at the front of the queue to be on their radar. So because of these open invitationals, you'll see a lot of talent coming in to British Wrestling Weekly and getting the opportunity to have an opportunity. And I think it's quite exciting. So, I mean, I know Zach Gibson is going to want to take part in it, but he can't because he won last year. So the only two people can't take part are the NGW Heavyweight Champion, at which at this point it's Nathan Cruz. It could end up being Rampage Brown, depending on what happens in the Team Warfare match, and also the guy who won it last year. And I think Zach Gibson, that's really going to affect him because he is either going to want to be NGW champion or Davey Boy Smith Cup winner, two tournaments in a row, and it can't happen.
Now, I might be speaking too quickly on this, but it appears this is the first time that you guys are kind of agreeing on something. No?
I guess it kind of is. Yeah, you're right. It's just every other country has their large tournament where they bring up the next bunch of stars and discover the next bunch of talent. In New Japan, you got Best of the Super Juniors, which is what Will Ospreay went on to win, who appeared in the Davey Boy Smith tournament before then. And then, I mean, these sorts of tournaments have fallen out of favour over the last, I don't know, decade. You know, King of the Ring and WWE's just been treated like a joke, really. But now, with the classic, the Cruiserweight Classic on the WWE Network, I can't believe I'm plugging that, I just said that. And now, they seem to be coming back into favour. And this is England's chance to have their own prestige tournament to discover the next bunch of lads.
So, Ollie, who are you picking as your winner?
I don't even know who's in it yet. Give me a minute. Well, the thing is, NGW's open door policy, where anyone from around the world can come in. Sami Callihan, I'd like to see him in it. He really impressed me against Mark Haskins the other week, and we've already talked about him in this programme. I'm a big fan of a lot of the NGW roster as it is. I love Bubblegum. I love Matt Myers. I love Wild Boar. I'd like to see one of the Gen X League guys get in it, you know, make a name for themselves even more so.
Well, you know, Bubblegum was in the finals last year. Yeah, yeah. And also, what's interesting is Wild Boar beat Nathan Cruz. It was by disqualification, but many people saw Cruz as the favourite. And I'm going to make a controversial prediction here, but I think it's going to be almost impossible to pick a winner until the conclusion of the Team Warfare match, because Rampage Brown wasn't in the cup last year, and if he goes into the cup this year, that's a game changer. And if, on the other hand, he loses the NGW title, I will put anything I own on Nathan Cruz wanting to go in there this year and rectify the fact that he didn't win the first one. So I think those two people involved, that's going to make a massive, massive difference. So until we know where they stand, and we will find out in just a matter of months here with the Team Warfare match, then all bets are off.
Well, we go from the Davey Boy Smith Memorial Cup to the Gen X Cup in just 7 days' time, where its current holder, Bubblegum, takes on the number one contender, El Ligero. If you're excited at the prospect of seeing two of the fastest men in British wrestling battle under Gen X 10-minute time limit rules, you're not alone. Take a look at this.
I'd say at the moment we're in what's called a YouTube generation. Everything's on demand, everything's now. Everybody wants something as fast as possible. The Gen X League delivers that. The Gen X League is a very fast-paced match because of the time limit that the competitors go in there, and they straight away think about, right, I've got to beat my opponent down as quickly as possible, get the pin, because otherwise the time's going to count out and we're not going to have a decisive winner. And the calibre of athlete that gets put into those matches are always, I'd say, genetically gifted when it comes to almost being superhuman. They can fly around, they can do things that are mind-boggling, but then you have, you know, guys such as Wild Boar in there who may not be that agile, but they bring something else to the match. It's a very, very varied division, but it's very exciting to watch. My best friend Matt Myers, he's a part of that group. And I know from speaking to him how exciting he finds it being in that league. When I think of two of the best Gen X wrestlers that we've got in this country, Ligero and Bubblegum, they come straight to mind. When I first started wrestling many years ago, I remember seeing Ligero and Bubblegum, and it was a moment to me that them two always stood out to me. And as the years have progressed and they've evolved over those years, there's still that part of me that really wants to see them compete. I love competing against them, don't get me wrong. I think when them two clash in that environment, it's going to be nothing but good things for people who are going to be watching. It's going to be nothing but good things for NGW. It's definitely an interesting match.
The current number one contender for the Gen X Cup, El Ligero, will be going up against the reigning league champion, Manchester's Bubblegum, next week. Plus, we prepare for the righteous Joe Connors to make his first appearance this season as he gets ready for an impending showdown with Liam Slater. That's all coming up in just 7 days, same time, same channel. Until then, thanks to my panel, Alex Shane and Ollie Davis. And thanks to Dave Bradshaw. I've been Francesca Wood, and we'll see you next time right here on NGW British Wrestling Weekly. Ta-ta for now.